Hello, welcome to this broadcast. It's an interesting day. Today I'm going to do something different. I'm going to talk about strategy. Today I'm going to look at two companies that have been trending the last few days. And my topic today is concerning political risk in a strategic environment. As you know very well, every business, every entity operates in an environment where there is competition, there is regulation, there is government. There are so many things that play out when it comes to business. I want to look at two companies as case studies to what we want to discuss today. One of them is Brookside Dairy. The other one would be Spectra, a gas cylinder manufacturing company. So we'll go straight to the Brookside and see some of the things that we want to discuss today. Now, if you look at this company, it's a company that started in 1993. It is among the biggest players in the milk industry. They control more than 50% market share. One thing about the company is that you discover it is founded, or the ownership is with the former president of Kenya. So it's a company that is being owned by a politician. It's a family company, family business. However, it is owned by the political class. So if you look at it, you discover that it has been controlling the market. It's the biggest in Eastern Central Africa by numbers, by assets, by strength. The company was enjoying an unfair advantage over other competition. At one point, the company was buying off other small dairy companies. So in a business environment, we call it unfair advantage. Why? It's because the company is able to buy off other companies. There is threat of entry by other players. So because the company is enjoying political goodwill, you find that the company is able to scare competition. Either they buy off competition or they create barriers to trade. They can create barriers to trade whereby you find other players find it difficult to come into the market, either through bureaucracy, red carpet, and so many things that can scare away a competition. So we call it unfair advantage in a business environment. Now, this is Brookside. But when there was change of regime, so there was a change in the political regime, the old government went, the new government came. So whenever there is a new government that comes in place, you find that the former business structure of these companies that enjoy political goodwill, they are threatened because they no longer will enjoy the political goodwill because there is a change of regime. So you find that such empires, they tend to collapse because the advantage that they are enjoying, sooner or later, the new regime will disorganize. Spectra. This is an LPG gas operating in Kenya and the East African area at large. Let me just say Eastern Central Africa at large. This company was founded in 1974 and it has been enjoying the same political goodwill, unfair advantage over other competitors because the owners of the company, they are people who are prominent in the political class. Now you want to look at these two companies and we look at the case studies, the advantage and the disadvantage of having companies that enjoy political goodwill. The first advantage is that they'll be able to manipulate competition. They'll be able to come up with barriers of entry. They're able to acquire markets for themselves. They're able to sell to the government directly. So such kind of people, you find that they're able to manipulate things here and there. Now, the advantage of operating under the canopy of political goodwill, whereby they enjoy unfair advantage, is that you are able to manipulate your markets. You're able to sell to the government directly without having to struggle. you're able to create barriers to trade whereby you block other players from participating in your current market. So there's a lot of things. You're able to create what you call a monopoly. You're able to ride on the pricing. You price according to what you desire. This is the advantage of the two companies, Spectre, which is a gas cylinder manufacturing company, and Brookside, which is a milk processing plant. These two companies, they have similar things in common. They enjoy market share, they enjoy political goodwill, they enjoy unfair advantage over competition. But here comes the risk, because the major environment affecting or touching these two companies is the political environment. Now, when there is a change of regime, there is what you call political risk. When another government comes in place, you tend to discover that they no longer enjoy the advantage they used to enjoy. The other government, of course, will come and bring some changes in regulation, remove the barriers to trade, whereby we see other players coming in. And you find such companies, they suffer a lot after there is a change of regime. So what are we learning here? When you're setting up a company, make sure that the foundation and the vision of your company or the unique selling proposition is not hinged on political goodwill. I'm not trying to say that political goodwill is bad, it's good, but how you approach it matters. Don't make it solely that the only thing that your company is enjoying is the political goodwill. You should make sure that you build superior products, superior services, good customer care, a good outreach to your clientele. There should be good promotion, a good marketing strategy, so that in case there is any change in regime, tax regime, or change in the government of the day, your business is not affected. So you tend to find that companies that usually enjoy political goodwill will tend to go down after there is a change of government. So we are learning here, when you're setting up a company, make sure you don't over depend on political goodwill, because the business environment changes constantly. The business environment changes constantly, so you cannot depend on it. Those are the lessons you are learning from Brookside Company and Spectre East Africa. Thank you so much.